Hello again. Thanks for logging on. I'm Chris Widlic. This is my friend Dave, a Colts expert by trade. Well, Dave, today was the first chance we got to visit with DeForest Buckner, big defensive acquisition in the offseason since he got here to the Colts training camp. What are your initial impressions of this guy?
Just his presence makes an impact on you. He's a huge dude, first of all. Like, I haven't been near him yet, but just seeing him on Zoom, you know, seeing him take up the entire screen, seeing a little bit of the video the Colts have sent out to us of him lifting weights here in the strength and conditioning period. And he's very thoughtful as well. So I enjoy hearing from him, and I'm eager to see what he actually does on the field when I can finally see, you know, what he does on the field.
We know he's a great playmaker for sure. He brings leadership skills, much like Philip Rivers on the other side of the ball. On the field, who do you think will benefit the most from his play?
A lot of people are saying Darius Leonard, and I get that. But first of all, let's point out that it's not like DeForest Buckner is a guy that's going to eat up blocks and let Darius or the linebackers like Anthony Walker run free behind him. He's a guy that's a disruptor. He's going to get up the field and try to get into the backfield. And that doesn't exactly free up Darius Leonard, but what it does is, it creates disruption. And Darius is a guy that thrives on disruption. He's not just a guy that racks up tackles. He gets sacks. He gets interceptions. He forces fumbles. He recovers fumbles. So from a little bit of chaos, Darius Leonard can thrive. He's number one. Number two for me is Kenny Moore. A guy like DeForest Buckner who plays in the middle of the field, Kenny Moore is similar, being a slot corner. He usually covers receivers, tight ends, running backs that are in the middle of the field. So just kind of in line with each other. If there's disruption up front, you can take advantage of that behind him. And also, Kenny, as we all know, loves to rush the passer himself. So if you get another big pass rusher in the middle, that might open up Kenny on the outside too.
What I find fascinating is he's got a chip on his shoulder, much like Darius Leonard. Mm-hmm. Neither one thinks they're getting enough respect in the NFL, which surprises me a little bit, but whatever it takes to drive a guy to play football, right?
You know, I spoke with the Indy Stars' Joel Erickson on this, so shout out to him, first of all, for kind of pointing me in this direction, seeing his thoughts on this. But, like, a couple of other star defensive players, like a Jamal Adams from the Jets, gets traded for two first-round picks. DeForest Buckner only got traded for one first-round pick. So, like, there's a difference between what people nationally think of DeForest Buckner and a guy like a Jamal Adams. Like, you're not the best of the best, at least that's what people think. You're kind of in that second tier. So as much as a $21 million man who got a first round pick traded for him can feel like he's being slighted, he does feel a little bit like he's being slighted, that he's not being discovered, or he's not being considered, rather, among that first tier of players on the defensive side in football. And Darius Leonard, as we know from the past 2-3 years, is the exact same way.
Fascinating stuff, Dave. Yeah. Thanks for the time. Be interesting to see who is more impactful, the offseason acquisition. Will it be Rivers? Touches the ball every time.
Yes.
Or will it be Buckner? Thanks for logging on. We'll see you next time.